when do I need to start dialysis? Really, I am not interested in starting dialysis at this time. So do I really need to start dialysis now? This is a classic question I hear every day in my clinical practice, and every time we meet with a patient that is getting close to needing to be on dialysis, I get asked that question. I'm Dr. Rifai. I'm a kidney specialist and a dialysis specialist. I'm the virtual nephrologist. And here is the solid facts that are as is for you to understand the answer to the question, when do I need to start dialysis? So as kidney disease progresses into stage 5, we look at a number called the glomerular filtration rate, or GFR. And if that GFR is 15 or less, which in a way can represent a percentage of kidney function, so 15% or less. And for patients who do not have diabetes but have only hypertension and their GFR is 10 or less, there has been a consensus that dialysis is recommended to be started. So these are the markers or numbers that we recommend to initiate or start dialysis. Now, there are many exceptions because this is a general guideline. This is not individualized for you. So if your GFR or your percentage is about 14.5 or even 14%, you feel well, you continue to work, you continue to go to work every day for 6 days a week, you have great energy, you have no symptoms, I would say maybe let's wait for one more month and see, because you're feeling well. Because we have found that that mark of 15% or 10% is a mark where patients will not do well and they start to deteriorate. They lose muscle mass, their appetite is bad, they start feeling tired, and so forth. For if that doesn't apply to you and you're at 14, or if you don't have diabetes and you're at 10 or 9 and you don't want to start dialysis, that is acceptable in my book, and that is a personal book, because you are feeling well. The moment you start feeling bad, your potassium starts to become difficult to control, you have more acid in your blood, you're nauseated, you have no energy, you're not sleeping well, you're itching, you're losing weight, then these are what we call subtle uremic findings, meaning that you have retained in your body so much kidney poisons that it is time to start dialysis. So we look not only at the absolute number of 15% or 10% if you're diabetic or not diabetic, but we also look at these subtle findings and subtle symptoms that you complain about. So when we make a decision, we don't say start dialysis tomorrow and go start and here's directions and the address. We sit down and we talk with you. We say, how are your symptoms? Are you feeling well? Are you feeling bad? Are you dwindling? We ask your partner, do you smell their breath to be what we call uremic, or smell like rotten eggs or even a dead animal? Your breath will smell that way. So if that is the case, we recommend dialysis. I want you to always ask yourself and ask your doctor when you go and visit, what is my percentage of GFR? Am I 15, 10? What is my creatinine? And then you ask yourself the series of the questions. How do I feel? Am I feeling bad? Am I deteriorating? Am I losing weight? Am I having poor appetite? And do I feel like I am just, the world is closing on me? Even though if you're 14.5 or you're even 15, that's the time to start dialysis. So there is a hard number, which is the 15 for diabetics and 10 for non-diabetics, the GFR or the percentage. And then there is the other symptoms. And that's the time where you talk to your nephrologist, talk to your family, and decide if those factors are influencing in a negative way, where you need to start as early as possible, where you feel so good, you're having great energy, continue to enjoy life, and so forth. Then you make a decision when to start dialysis. There is one warning though. Some people will pretend they feel well and they don't know how bad they feel. And those people will feel so much better once we start them on dialysis. And then once the number reached to 7, then there is a life risk with those electrolyte abnormalities that can lead to cardiac arrest as a result of severe elevated potassium or fluid retention and fluid in the lungs. So it is not a clear decision when to start dialysis, but it is clear enough where are your landmarks, and you would know what to do and what to say and how to talk to your nephrologist and how to talk to your family and decide when to start dialysis. With this, I hope I made it somewhat clear that it is a back and forth bi-directional decision with your nephrologist about when to start dialysis. I wish you the best. Stay healthy and safe. I'm Dr. Rifai, the virtual nephrologist.